This conference will now be recorded.
स्टूडेंट्स, कल हम लोगों ने जो डिस्कस किया था, लास्ट टॉपिक जो मैंने आपको एक छोटा सा व्यू दिया था, वो था हमारा टाइप कास्टिंग. टाइप कास्टिंग, राइट? एंड इन टाइप कास्टिंग आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट फाइव फंक्शंस. वन इज इंट, वन इज फ्लोट, वन इज कॉम्प्लेक्स, वन इज बूल एंड लास्ट इज एसटीआर. दीज फाइव फंक्शन वी हैव एंड दीज फाइव फंक्शन आर यूज टू चेंज वन डेटा टाइप इनटू अनदर डेटा टाइप. इज इट क्लियर? एज आई टोल्ड यू यस्टरडे अबाउट दिस कंसेप्ट कि दीज डेटा टाइप्स आर यूज टू चेंज वन डेटा टाइप इनटू अनदर डेटा टाइप. लेट सपोज इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ए इंट फंक्शन फर्स्ट, ओके, एंड दीज आर व्हाट, दीज आर द इनबिल्ट फंक्शंस. इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट इंट फंक्शन फर्स्ट, सो हाउ इट इज वर्क्स. इफ आई पास एनी वैल्यू और शुड आई से एनी आर्ग्यूमेंट, वन थिंग इज हेयर विच मस्ट बी कंसिडरेबल दैट दिस इज ए फंक्शन. फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट, एंड यू नो हाउ टू फाइंड आउट ए फंक्शन, वॉट इज द लुक ऑफ ए फंक्शन, वी कैन से दिस इज ए फंक्शन. सो वी ऑल नो दैट एवरी फंक्शन हैव दिस पैरेंथिसिस साइन, एग्री ना, बाई विच वी कैन अंडरस्टैंडेबल दैट दिस इज ए फॉर्म ऑफ ए फंक्शन, राइट? और दीज राउंड ब्रैकेट इन द प्रोग्रामिंग जर्नली कॉल्ड पैरेंथेसिस, यू नो अबाउट इट, राइट? सो दीज पैरेंथेसिस, इफ दीज पैरेंथेसिस हैविंग विद एनी आइडेंटिफायर, सो दैट आइडेंटिफायर इज नॉट ए नॉर्मल आइडेंटिफायर, इट्स बिकम ए फंक्शन, राइट? सो इफ इट इज ए फंक्शन, सो वी नो दैट वी हैव टू टाइप ऑफ थिंग्स वी हैव लर्न अबाउट इट, दैट फंक्शन कैन बी विदाउट आर्ग्यूमेंट एंड फंक्शन कैन बी विद आर्ग्यूमेंट. सो दिस इंट फंक्शन, और हेयर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑल फ्लोट फंक्शन, कॉम्प्लेक्स फंक्शन, एसटीआर फंक्शन, बूल फंक्शन, दे ऑल आर द फंक्शन विद आर्ग्यूमेंट. सो वी हैव टू पास सम आर्ग्यूमेंट इन साइड दिस फंक्शन एंड दिस फंक्शन रिटर्न अस ए वैल्यू इन फॉर्म ऑफ इंटीजर, बिकॉज द फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज द इंटीजर. So if I pass any other value inside it, so it will return me value in form of integer only. Okay, let's take a simple example. Okay, just wait. Just I'm moving. Just wait. It's about to open. Just a few seconds required. Okay, done. So two times my computer opened this cell, so I closed once. Okay, so if I check here that int we have and I am passing some 10.110, right? What it will return? Anyone can able to give the answer? What it will return? It will return 10 only, because if I'm passing here 10.10, so this is a float value and this function return that value into the integer. Next observation, if I pass any bool value, let's see, any bool value, complex at the last. So if I pass any bool value, so I'm passing true here, right? So if I'm passing true here, What will be the output? Yes, Tanuj Goyal, Tanuj one. Yes, good. Anushka Vaidushi, Kalash, Tanu, Soham. That's good. So we received one because you all know internally that true variable or that true value or true constant return us a one. Okay. And if I pass here any false, if suppose I pass false here, F must be capital. If I pass false here, then it will return what? Zero, right? And one thing is here that if I pass here in comma, quotation marks 1, 2, 3. So you know that this is what this type of value is, the integer value. Okay. So if I check, this is written one. Okay. One more thing I want to show you. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3 comma, and is pure ko main dal deta hu bachcho type ke andar. So we can find out the ki whatever the this function is changing. So which type of int type? Is it clear or not? Right? So this will showing you that ki string data can also be changed into the integer type. One more thing, one more observation I have. If I int 10.10.2312, if I am taking, and this is an integer type, then what will be the output? Okay, so the output is a invalid literal int with base 10.10.2. It means what? This is a value error. Listen carefully with this point, that if you want to change any string literal bole to constant, okay, if you want to change any string literal in that situation, that literal must be base 10 only. That literal must be base 10 only. You know, this 10.12 possible if this is not a string type. Let's see here. Okay, I'm just using my pen. Yes, right. Now this is, let's see there. In 10.10, right now I'm taking, but at that time this 10.10 is what is a float value. Yes, happily possible. And if I'm taking any integer value inside the string, yes, happily possible to change. But if other than 10 base, other than base 10, because integer having the base 10, right? Remember, because this is a decimal value, other than base 10, if I want to convert that value from as a string to integer, so it's always return us a value error. Okay, so boolean is happily possible, integer as a form of the string happily possible, float happily possible, but in case of a string integer, if you have a string and that string having a decimal data, that is possible to convert into the integer form. But if other than integer, if you passing inside this function, that always return you a value error. Let's take one more example with the same concept. Okay, if suppose I'm passing, sorry, int 0b111, you know what is the meaning of 0b, right? So 0b is what? Because it is a type of the integer. Internally, if you are not using this int function, you know that if you are not using this int function, definitely octal, hexa and binary all are converted to the int, no problem at all. If you are trying to do inside the string, in that case 0111, it is a binary value, but now that binary value into the change of the string data type. So if we are going to do this, so it will again give you a value error. Is it clear to all with the string conversion to int data, string conversion to int data? If string data having a value, a string data having a value only base 10, only base 10, base 10 ka matlab hai keval decimal value ko hi string data se integer data mein convert kiya ja sakta hai. Is it clear? Only a single point you have to be remembered. Okay, in case of the integer, if integer having a value other than base 10, that means what? That means the value inside the string, inside the double quotation or single quotation marks, if the string, if the data is other than the base 10, so that data will not be converted. Okay, let's take one more example. If I'm taking int 10, agree or not? If I'm taking int 10, I'm not taking int and colon sign, single quote sign 10. No, I'm writing English int 10, T-E-N. So is it possible to convert into the integer or not? Yes. Yes, error. That's good. That's good. Type value error again. Why? Because I am saying that 10 is a string value, pure string value. 10 is a string data. And if that string must consider any base value with 10, any base value with 10, that happily possible to convert it into the integer form. Otherwise, a value error will be shown. Is it clear? ठीक है? Any question? Okay. No reply means all clear. Okay. The next observation is, just wait. Yeah. The next observation is, if, okay, we, up to now we have discussed that int having 10.10, so return what? 10. Okay, int 1 2 3, so return what? 1 2 3. Int true, return what? 1. Int false, return what? 0. Right? Then what? 0. If we are trying to do int 10.10, in that case value error. In that case value error. Okay, value error. That string must contain base 10 data. Like this is happily possible. If you are trying to do like this, so it will generate value. Okay. The one thing is left. We have converted bool, we have converted integer, we have converted float. Right. One thing is left, complex. So be careful with this data type, that if we are trying to convert any complex data into the integer, so it always take a type error. So what that means, a complex data cannot be converted into the integer. Simple. There is no value error. This is the type error. Type error means we are wrong type conversion doing, or we are wrong type casting doing. जो हम लोग type casting कर रहे हैं वो absolutely wrong है. This is not considerable. Okay. So what we are done? So we done int 10 plus 10j, right? Any complex number we are trying to convert into the integer, the output will be type error will be the output. Okay, so this will be the error. Next picture we have float function. Okay, so yes, this float function also take one argument and change that argument into the in float type. Okay, float. Just observe. Okay, now if I'm taking float 10, what will be the output? Yes, anyone? Yes, Tanu, 10.0, Divya, 10.0, Tanu, absolutely right, Anushka, good, very good, Monica, very good, Kailash, Tina, badhiya, good. So, yes, absolutely right, it will convert 10.10, yes, happily possible. Now, Next one is if I want to convert float and I am passing true. Possible or not? Possible or not? Happily possible, and it will return 1.0. No problem at all. If I am trying to pass any Boolean data type which is false, so 1.0 it will be out. Let's suppose if I am passing 10.10.102, so yes, happily possible now, because that string contained a float data, that is contained a float data, so that is possible to convert into the float type. Let's suppose I am taking this example again, and I am passing inside the type function, so we can got the exact output. So this is the float. You can also do this float 11.12, and I'm passing to a some variable, and after it I can check the type of a type type of a, so it will return what? It will return float. Yes, so one more observation is if I pass float 10 only, yes, happily possible, because float can be converted integer data in base 10 as well as float floating decimal also, right? But in case of integer, this option cannot be changed because we are passing float data, and that is not considered by integer. Is it clear to all up to now? Okay, one more important complex data type. If we are trying to pass any complex data type with inside the float data type, so yes, again a type error will be here. Okay, so why? Because simple understanding that we can't convert, simply saying Python simply saying cannot convert complex to float. Same error with the integer, cannot convert. Let's see this point. Cannot convert complex to int. This is highlighted part. Cannot convert complex to int, right? The same error is there. Cannot convert complex to float. Not possible. Okay. Other than the all possible things are there, that let's see a listed form. If I'm passing 10, so it will return what? 10.0, right? If I'm passing float true, it will return what? 1.0. If I'm passing float false, it will return 0.0, right? If I'm passing float 10.123, so definitely possible. Then what is the output? Output will be 10.123 in the integer, in the float form. Okay. Next one is, yes, suppose if I'm passing float 10 only, in that situation, what will be the output? 10 only, right? 10.0 only. In that case, the complex load, comma 10 plus 20j. 10 plus 20j. So it will return error. Type error it is showing. Is it clear? Float data type, float conversion. Okay. The next one is very important. The next one is complex data type. Next one is complex data type. Okay. Listen one. Complex data type, complex function provide two forms of function. Okay, two forms of function. The first form is form one. First form is complex x means only a single argument. In this case, the x plus 0j will be the conversion. X plus 0j means the real part considered as x and the rest of part 0j. Let's see a simple example in it. Okay, I close this and the fresh window I am opening again. Okay, let's see in this complex 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 10 I am taking only, so you can complex 10 I am taking only. Okay, so output will be there my mistake is some space is not allowed, right? So 10 plus 0j, you know the 10 value considered as x and the rest of imaginary part will be considered as 0. Is it clear? The next form is form 2. Then what will be the form? Complex and having two arguments happily possible. So x plus y j, it will be the output. Let's see. Complex 10, 20. So 10 plus 20j will be the output. Okay, so and one thing is we have complex 10.13. So possible to all, and one thing is 10.123, 10.1234. So this is also possible because you know that as a real part and imaginary part, both places any float and integer value allowed it. Even inside the real part, you know very well complex 0b11 plus 10 0b11 comma 10. In that situation, happily possible at all, because at the place of real number, we have already discussed about it, at the place of real number we can also pass any other base of integer, like apart from the decimal, like binary, like the hexadecimal, like octal. Is it clear to all? Next observation, suppose I am passing complex true, then what will be the output? Complex true. Anyone guess? Yes, anyone able to give the answer of this question? 1 plus 0j, definitely this is the right answer to all of you. 1 plus 0j. Now one more bit interesting, let's see. Hope you must give the answer false. Now yes, Anushka 0.0 plus 0j, Tanuj Goyal 0j, Vidushi 1 plus 0j. Vidushi, how it is possible 1 plus 0j? Not possible. False means 0. Divya, okay. Tanu, Vashu, Kailash, badiya, good. Anybody? Ekta, Vidushi, okay. Vidushi, you change your answer. Good. Chaliye. So, main aapko bata dun. Vidushi, एकता, कैलाश, आशीष, वसु, तनु, अनुराग, दिव्या, तनुज नहीं, दिव्या, आप सबका आंसर गलत है. ओनली द राइट आंसर इज तनुज गोयल, दैट 0j ओनली. बिकॉज इफ यू राइट मैथमेटिकली 0j, सो दैट 0 हैव नो सिग्निफिकेंट. ओके, that 0 have no significant, that is the reason only it return 0j, only 0j. Is it clear? Now the next one is complex complex true comma false yes happily possible 1 plus 0 j because at the place of imaginary number j because j is the suffix here so this is will be the output okay so we have done up to now complex to boolean to complex integer to complex and float to complex okay because complex number inside the python considered as inside the bracket only okay considered as a inside the bracket only because having two parts 10 plus real and imaginary for the better calculation python internally show or internally store that data inside the parenthesis only for the complex number okay if suppose next important discussion I am passing complex 1 2 3 possible or not yes anybody able to give this answer no good bahut acha vashu no badhiya good yes swam tell me what is the answer अरे आई एम पासिंग ए सिंगल आर्ग्यूमेंट ओनली एज ए इंटीजर फॉर्म सिंगल आर्ग्यूमेंट एज ए इंटीजर फॉर्म सो इट विल कंसिडर्ड एज ए रियल नंबर एंड द आउटपुट विल बी 1 2 3 प्लस 0 जे वेरी सिंपल गाइज व्हाई यू आर टेकिंग सो मच टाइम ओके द नेक्स्ट वन इज दिस इज मोर इंटरेस्टिंग ओके जस्ट आई ओपनिंग माई नेक्स्ट वेट या I open my next window. Let's see this. If I use complex 1 2 3 comma 1 10. Now, tell me the output. Ekta you write definitely. Okay. So now Tanu 1 2 3 10 1 2 3 0 1 2 3 0 Tanoj okay. Anushka good. बहुत बढ़िया आनंद जी इसमें पानी भर देना बढ़िया गुड शोहम जी साइड बाय साइड लैपटॉप पे रन करा रहे हैं आप इस कोड को हैं क्यों भाई शोहम साइड बाय साइड लैपटॉप पे रन हो रहा है ये कोड नो सर अच्छा चलो कोई बात नहीं So complex 1 2 3 comma 1 0 definitely it's written the error. Listen one thing. If you want to convert any string integer data into the complex number, so only a single argument can be a string. Okay? So there is a type error. Complex cannot take second argument if the first is a string okay it means that inside the complex only a single integer argument can be passed is it clear a single even if you pass two arguments so this is not possible in case of a string yes happily Happily 10 is there and I am using this and what will be the output this is 1 10 10 10 plus 0 j happily possible if we are try to take two argument of string type or should I say the first argument of string type so it will not convert into the complex number only a single argument can be passed in case of we are passing a string argument okay chale so up to this we have covered complex Int to complex, float to complex, bool to complex, bool to complex, bool to complex, str to complex. वहां पर इस पर रखवा टेबल. अच्छा ओके. सो नेक्स्ट वी हैव जस्ट ऑब्जर्व. डन. ओके नेक्स्ट वी हैव बूल डेटा टाइप. नेक्स्ट वी हैव नेक्स्ट वी हैव बूल डेटा टाइप. ओके सो इट्स वेरी सिंपल एंड लिटिल बिट इंटरेस्टिंग. ओके लेट्स सपोज if I am taking bool and I am taking one, what will be the output? Yes, even able to. Yes, very good. Anushka, Anuragni, Anushka, Tanu, Tanuj, Ekta, Kailash, Ekta, Vashu. Good. So definitely true. Okay. If I pass bool false, what will be the output? Yes, anyone? Zero. Good. Yes, definitely false, right? If I pass zero, so definitely false. If suppose I pass minus five, what will be the output? Yes, anyone? Good, error. Tanu Goyal, error. Good. Tanu, error. Badhiya. Anurag, error. Good. Error. Good. Okay. Listen one thing very carefully. Listen. If the argument inside the Boolean data, very, very careful with this Boolean data. This is little bit different. Okay. If argument is non-zero value, है ना? If argument is non-zero value, हाँ, ALUE, non-zero value, always considered as true. Okay, if the argument in the bool function is non-zero value matlab plus minus ki koi bhi ho, bas zero nahi honi chahiye, like 1, 2, 3, -10, -10.24, any value can be there but must not be zero. So it will return true, otherwise false. Okay, so it will return true. If I am taking bool -12.3, so it will return true. Huh? If I am passing zero value, either 0.0, either zero only, always consider as false. Is it clear? The next one is I am passing bool python. Yes. Anyone able to give the answer? Bool python. True. Oh, good. Tanuj. Tanu, true. Good. Anushka, true. Good. Okay. So, yes, definitely true. One more question I have. I am giving this string. Simple. okay, so it will return true value only, right? Chala gaya tha, right? Ekta, now you are able to listen. Ekta, are you able to hear me, Ekta? Okay, okay. Yes, theek hai. I think network ka problem tha, ek second ka. So now it's okay. All things are absolutely fine now. Listen once more carefully. If someone is left to listen, that if in case of string, if we are passing any string data into the bool, any string data into the bool, in that case only, if we passing the empty string, it will return false. If we pass any white space character, either single space, tab space, backslash n, backslash t, any white space character, so it will return true. In detail, we learn about this white space character, okay? And if we pass any string having some data, that also return true value, okay? One more considerable point, that is about the complex. If suppose I am passing any complex number, then what happen? If suppose bool 10 plus 20 j I am passing, then what it will return? True. True it will return. If suppose I am passing bool 0 plus 0 j, in that case it will return o. I am writing o, that is my mistake. I passed o at place of 0. I passed o, sorry. So again I am writing 0 plus 0, so definitely it will return false. So in case of boolean function, it will never return you any type error, value error at all. In case of boolean function, it always return you a either true value or either false value. I think you all are able to understand this concept, right? Any question, any query? Okay, the next and the last topic we have, so we will not continue today guys, because I have one more class from 1 o'clock. So tomorrow we discuss the last topic is str data type. We discuss the tomorrow we discuss this topic. And thank you. Now I am disconnecting my class. Keep practice. This video will be uploaded on the group, so you can see again. Okay, I am disconnecting.